Hello, in this video you will learn Firefly algorithm using example, and this algorithm is used to solve different optimization problems. So let's see what is Firefly algorithm. Topics covered in this video: what is this algorithm all about, how this algorithm is working, how we can generate the population of fireflies, and how we can compute the light intensity value for each firefly, how we can update the position for each firefly. And then we will learn this algorithm with an example, and then we have certain applications where this algorithm is used. What is this algorithm? It is a metaheuristic algorithm and inspired by the flashing behavior of fireflies. You know about fireflies? So this algorithm is inspired by their flashing behavior. So we have certain assumptions, and on the basis of these assumptions, this algorithm is implemented. So let's see these assumptions step by step. First is, fireflies are attracted toward each other, and how we will show the attractiveness between two fireflies. For that, we will compute the brightness value for each firefly. So attractiveness is proportional to brightness. That is, less brighter firefly is attracted toward brightest firefly. Done. So according to first assumption, fireflies are attracted toward each other, and we will represent the attractiveness between two fireflies using brightness value. Less brighter firefly is attracted toward brighter one. Done. Second assumption is, attractiveness decreases as the distance between two fireflies increases. This is clear. When the distance between two firefly will increase, the brightness value decrease. As you can see here, the brightness is decreasing as the distance between two firefly is increasing. Done. Third assumption is, if brightness for the both is same, then firefly move randomly. So when you compute the brightness value for each firefly and you got the same value for both, then firefly will move randomly. For that, we will use random walk for the firefly. Last assumption is, new solutions are generated by the random walk and the attraction of the firefly. As we know, less brighter firefly is attracted toward the brighter firefly. So how we will generate the new solution? According to their attraction values, that is the brightness value, or you can say the light intensity value that we will compute, and we will perform random walk. Suppose in this case, this is the less brighter firefly and this is attracted toward this one. So here we will perform the random walk. Random walk means step size, smaller steps that this firefly will take toward this one. Done. And for the random steps, you can see here we are using random walk. We are using random numbers for the random walk. So this is the firefly optimization algorithm. We have simple six steps. First, initialize parameters, and then we will generate the population for the n fireflies. Calculate the fitness value, check this condition is true, and if this condition is true, update the position and the light intensity value for the each firefly. In the last step, report best. So step one is initialize parameter. So we have, suppose for example, 20 fireflies, and the value for gamma, beta, alpha you can see. So now we will initialize the population size for the 20 fireflies. You can see the maximum number of iteration is 50, suppose, and the dimension is 10, and the upper bound, lower bound, you can see value. So the position for the each firefly, so randomly you can generate the position for each firefly using this equation, lower bound plus upper bound minus lower bound into this one. So when you will compute this in MATLAB, I got this is the initial population generated for 20 fireflies having 10 dimensions. Done. Second step is we will compute the fitness value, or you can say this is the light intensity value for the each firefly. Here we will compute the light intensity in order to know which one is brighter and which one is less brighter. So in order to know the brightness, that is the attractiveness between two fireflies, we will compute the fitness value, that is the light intensity between the two fireflies. So for this, we will use objective function, this one. Here we will put the values that you computed here. And you can see I computed the fitness value for the first 6 fireflies. So for simplicity, I'm using just 6 firefly for the comparison. And we will see how we can update their position and the light intensity. Now check the condition. Initially we have value for the counter is 1. Condition is true. Move to next step. Now we will update the position for the each firefly. And in order to update the position, we will check the condition here. So first, initialize the loop. I equal to 1 to n minus 1. N is here 6. I'm using here just 6 firefly. So value for I is 1 to 5. That is 6 minus 1 is 5. Value for j is I plus 1 to n. Value for I will use from the here, and the here n is 6. Then we will check the light intensity, or you can say the fitness value that you computed here, this one. If condition is true, then we will update the position, and else we will move the firefly randomly if there is no any brighter one for the comparison. Let's see how this is working. Okay, as we want to update the position when this condition is true, so we will perform here random walk also. So how we can compute the position, that is a new solution. So for this, this is the mathematical model for the movement of the firefly toward another firefly. So here we can update the position for the firefly. This is the new solution. Here this is the current position of the firefly, and this is the attractiveness that we will compute between two fireflies, and this is the step size that firefly will take against other. Done. Now here you can see we have value for attractiveness, and you can see this is the distance between two fireflies, and this is the brightness value, and this is for the new solution. Now when we want to update the solution for the random walk, for this we will use this equation for the random movement of the firefly. Here in the initial position of the firefly, we will add step size. So new solution for the random walk is current position plus step size. Now we will update the position and the light intensity for the each firefly. Initially we have value for I 1 to n minus 1, that is 1 to 6 minus 1, that is 5. So we have value for I is 1 to 5, j is 1 to I plus 1 to n. So initially we have value for I is 1, so j is 2 to n, that is 2 to 6. Value for I is 1 and value for j is 2. Put the value here, j is 2, I is 1. Here you can see intensity value for 2 is this one, and the for the first one is this one. Here you can see condition is true, so we will move firefly I toward firefly j. So how we can move firefly? For that we will use this equation. This is the new solution that we will generate for the first firefly. In this case we are going to update the position of the firefly 1, that is this firefly, because value for I is 1, so we are going to update the new solution for this firefly. Here new solution is current position of that firefly plus attractiveness value, and here we have step size. Now you can see here we have distance between two fireflies can be computed using this equation. So this is the mathematical model in order to compute the distance between two fireflies, that is the distance between two fireflies at position xi and xj. For this, we will use the initial position that we computed. So here we have value for I is 1, value for j is 2. So we will compute this, and this is for the attraction, that is the attractiveness function. So for this, for the distance between two fireflies, put the values here, and in MATLAB I computed the distance between these two fireflies as this one. Now we will compute the attraction toward two fireflies. For this we are using this function, so put all the values and I got this. Now we will put these values here, and you can compute the step size using this equation. Put the value of the first firefly, and this is the attraction that we recently computed, and here we have step size. When I put all the values, I got this is the new position of the firefly, and I computed the fitness value, or you can say new light intensity for the first firefly, this one. So we updated the new light intensity or the fitness value for the first firefly. Now check conditions for second firefly. Now value for I is 2, j is 3. Put the value here. Light intensity at 3 is 16.8422, and I is 2, that is this one. You can see here condition is again true. So I is attracted toward j, that is I will move toward j. So we are going to update the position for this firefly, this one. So this is moving toward j. So for this again you will compute the distance, attractiveness and the position. Put all the values and I got the result. This is the new position and this is the new fitness value, or you can say new light intensity for the second firefly. Now check the condition. This time value for I is 3 and j is 3 plus 1, that is 4. Put the value ij, i3. Here i4 is 6.1690, i3 is 168422. Done. Condition is false this time. So in this case we will move firefly randomly. That means we are going to update the position for I equal to 3, that is for third firefly. So in order to update the position for the third firefly, we will add step size in the initial position of the third firefly. Put all the values and I got this is the new position for the third firefly at iteration 2. That value you will use this value in the second iteration, and the intensity value for this firefly is this one. Now we will check for the I equal to 4 and j is now 5. Check the value. This is greater than this. It means firefly I will move toward j. So for i4, now we are going to update the value for this firefly for 4. Compute the distance, attractiveness, position, and I got this one. So this is the new intensity value or the new fitness value for the fourth firefly. Now we have a value counter for I is 5, j is 6. You can see i6 is this one, 1.1329, and i5 is this one. In this case condition is true as this value is not greater. So in this case we will move firefly 5 randomly. So after that you can see here we will add some step size here in the initial position of the firefly at counter 1. So you can see here we are using a step size, and for the step size we are using random numbers. As you can see here we are using random values here, so each time we will got different result. And we will compute the step size for each firefly, and each time you will get the different output. So in this case, you can update the position like this, and the new value is this. Now we have value for I. You can see I is 6 and j is now 6 plus 1 7. So you know we can't move now, so this will stop. Now we have I equal to 6, so for this there is no comparison, so we're going to move this firefly randomly, and in the random case we will add some step size in the initial position of the firefly, that is the current position plus the step size. And you can see here we have the all the fitness value that we computed, and this is the less bright attractive among all, and this is the most attractive. So after this, in the second iteration, when you will start second iteration, you will check whether the values you will compute here, that is the new position you computed for the each firefly, that is within bound or not, that you used between minus 100 to 100. So you will check these conditions. If the values are between upper bound and lower bound or not. If this is not between the bound, so we will update the values again. After that, we have certain applications where you can use this algorithm in the feature selection, fault detection, to solve different dynamic problem, and this is used to solve different non-linear optimization problems. So in Firefly algorithm, we will initialize parameters, generate the population, compute the light intensity value, and then we will update the position, and then we will compare the values. After that, we will generate the batch solution. So that's all about this video. If you have any question, you can comment below, and I provided all the important links in the description box. And if you have any question, you can comment below, and thanks for watching.